En esta sección usted aprenderá acerca del azúcar baja o lo que también puede ser llamado hipoglicemia. Cualquier nivel de azúcar menor a 70 es considerada azúcar baja o hipoglicemia. Esto puede pasar por varias razones, siendo la más común administrarse mucha insulina. Esto ocurre ya sea porque hubo un error al contar los carbohidratos o un error al calcular la dosis de la insulina para la comida. Azúcar baja también puede ocurrir cuando hay ejercicio extra o prolongado sin haber tenido extra carbohidratos o cometer un error al sacar la insulina o marcar la pluma de insulina. Los días en que usted deberá de estar más pendiente de niveles bajos en el azúcar incluye los días en que su niño es más activo de lo normal, como cuando hacen ejercicio, van a nadar o juegan deportes. Los síntomas del azúcar baja incluyen sudor, temblores, dolor de cabeza, confusión, debilidad, latidos rápidos del corazón, irritabilidad o cambio en la personalidad. En ocasiones usted podría pensar que estos son relacionados con el comportamiento, pero cuando tenga dudas, siempre compruebe el azúcar en la sangre. Independientemente de lo anterior, siempre compruebe el azúcar en la sangre antes de tratarla. Usted utilizará la regla de 15 para tratar cualquier azúcar debajo de 70. Esto básicamente significa 15 gramos de carbohidratos de acción rápida cada 15 minutos hasta que el azúcar en la sangre sea mayor a 70. Esto podría ser 4 onzas de jugo o soda regular, 2 paquetes de Smarties, una cucharada de jarabe de maíz, corn syrup o miel, o 3 paquetes de azúcar, un tubo de gel de glucosa . Una vez el azúcar ha sido corregida, usted le dará seguimiento con 15 gramos de carbohidratos más proteína a menos que sea hora de la comida. Es muy importante recordar que esto debe de hacerse aún si ya se están preparando para la comida. Usted aún administrará la insulina para la comida que coma después de que el azúcar esté arriba de 70. Hay algunas comidas que deberán de ser evitadas cuando se está tratando niveles bajos de azúcar en la sangre. Esto incluye cualquier tipo de dulce duro, Skittles o caramelos de goma. Todos estos representan riesgo de asfixia para alguien que puede tener confusión debido a los niveles bajos de azúcar en la sangre. Usted tampoco querrá usar leche, galletas de mantequilla de maní o chocolate. Todos estos toman mucho tiempo en subir el nivel de azúcar en la sangre. Ocasionalmente, el azúcar en la sangre puede bajar lo suficiente para causar que el paciente tenga una convulsión o pierda la conciencia. Si esto ocurre, usted tendrá una inyección de emergencia a mano para utilizar llamada glucagon. Esta inyección deberá de estar disponible para ser utilizada tanto en casa como en la escuela. Hay un orden específico en las instrucciones de la escuela para hacer uso de glucagon mientras está en escuela. Hay un par de cosas a recordar con respecto a glucagon. Siempre póngase en contacto con el equipo de diabetes si glucagon ha sido administrado. También no puede haber sobredosis.
Welcome to the Lilly Glucagon Tutorial. Glucagon is used to treat severe low blood sugar, a condition known as severe hypoglycemia. This is also sometimes called insulin coma or insulin reaction resulting from severe low blood sugar. This tutorial will discuss the symptoms and risks of severe hypoglycemia and demonstrate how to use glucagon to help in times of emergency. We often describe glucagon by saying, "You might not need it, but you'll be glad it's there." Here's why. Glucagon is a potentially life-saving treatment for severe hypoglycemia. An injection of glucagon triggers a burst of glucose into the blood, quickly stopping the symptoms of severe hypoglycemia. If you take insulin, you should have at least one glucagon emergency kit on hand, just in case you need it. Let's begin by discussing the symptoms and risks in the hypoglycemia orientation. Hypoglycemia happens. You or a loved one takes insulin to control blood sugar, But sometimes you might miss a meal, exercise too much, or not eat enough food for the amount of insulin you've taken. Any of these situations can lead to low levels of blood sugar. The good news is that if you can treat mild or moderate hypoglycemia quickly, you can often prevent this situation from getting worse and avoid a severe hypoglycemic episode. This is why it's important to recognize the symptoms of mild or moderate low blood sugar. A person with hypoglycemia may be pale, sweaty, dizzy, or irritable. They might also be confused, drowsy, weak, trembling, or hungry. So look for these symptoms and take action by eating or drinking a fast-acting source of sugar like juice, regular soda, or glucose tablets. If not treated quickly, mild or moderate low blood sugar can become severe. In these severe cases, you may become unconscious or experience seizures or convulsions, and therefore may be unable to take any sugar by mouth. If your low blood sugar gets so severe that you cannot help yourself, then you'll need a glucagon injection. So be prepared. If you don't already have a Lilly glucagon emergency kit, talk to your doctor. You should also talk to the people who need to be prepared to help you in case of a severe hypoglycemic event. Think about the people you interact with on a daily basis, like family, friends, coworkers, and exercise partners. Share this training program or the accompanying Lilly glucagon brochure with these people so they will be better prepared in a severe hypoglycemic emergency. Now let's take a look at the directions for use. The Lilly glucagon emergency kit has easy-to-follow directions for your family, caregivers, friends, and coworkers. There are 5 steps involved in giving someone an injection of glucagon. Before you begin, familiarize yourself with the kit, which consists of a syringe, cap, and vial. Step 1. Flip off the seal from the vial of glucagon. Step 2. Remove the needle cover from the syringe. Now, insert the needle into the rubber stopper on the vial and inject the entire contents of the syringe into the vial. Step 3. Remove the syringe from the vial and gently swirl the bottle until the liquid becomes clear. Remember, the glucagon should not be used unless the liquid is clear and has a water-like consistency. Step 4. Holding the vial upside down, insert the same syringe and slowly withdraw all of the liquid. Step 5. At this point, you're ready to give the injection. The usual injection site is the top of the thigh. Insert the needle and then inject the glucagon. For children weighing less than 44 pounds, use half the amount, or 0.5 milligrams. When done, turn the person on his or her side to prevent choking. It's extremely important that the person wakes up within 15 minutes after you give the injection. If he or she does not wake up within 15 minutes, give another dose of glucagon and get medical help immediately. When the person awakens and is capable of swallowing, give them a fast-acting source of sugar. For example, try a regular soft drink or juice. Make sure to follow that drink with a longer-acting source of sugar, such as cheese and crackers. And if you haven't done so already, notify the person's doctor. Remember, your healthcare provider should always be told whenever an episode of severe low blood sugar occurs. Prolonged unconsciousness may be harmful, so it's important to follow these steps quickly and carefully. Please see the important safety information and the information for the user at the end of this program for more important facts about using Lilly glucagon. Now let's consider some important tips to help you stay prepared. Tip number 1, educate. First, make sure your friends and family know that if you become unconscious, you will need to receive a glucagon injection. Inform them that your doctor or a medical professional should always be notified afterwards. Have your friends and family view this training program or the accompanying Lilly glucagon brochure for detailed instructions. Tip number 2, inform. Show your family, friends, and coworkers where you keep your kit. If you're unconscious, they'll need to know where to find it. Tip number three, practice. A person who has never given an injection probably will not be able to do so in an emergency. So help your family and friends practice and become more comfortable by letting them give you one of your usual insulin injections. Tip number four, check dates. Keep track of the expiration date stamped on the vial label. Plan to ask your doctor about a new kit before this date. Don't be caught in an emergency with an expired kit. Tip number five, ask. You may ask your doctor for a second Lilly Glucagon emergency kit. That way, you can be prepared at home and at work. Thank you for viewing this training program. And remember, glucagon is a potentially life-saving treatment for severe hypoglycemia. So having at least one glucagon emergency kit on hand is important. It's also important to instruct yourself and others on how to use the kit in case it might be needed in a severe hypoglycemia emergency.
Low blood sugars can be scary for children and their parents. It is important that you are always prepared to treat low blood sugars as they happen.